Earth is literally breaking all over the world. In recent years, reports from all corners claim that the Earth is cracking. Sinkholes have consumed entire neighborhoods, including homes, streets, and even people. The ground has developed so deep fissures that a person could fall through them and be completely buried. Additionally, in some instances, entire islands have been obliterated by the water. These occurrences, despite the reality that they might appear to be plucked from the pages of a science fiction book, are real and are occurring increasingly. In this video, we will discuss some of the factors contributing to the Earth's cracking and some of the things we can do to stop it. At Northwest University in Xi'an, China, the country's first modern ground fissure occurred in 1950. Fissures in the ground quickly spread across the country, particularly following the Xingtai earthquake in 1966 and the Tangshan earthquake in 1976. By 2000, over 4,000 ground fissures had been found in 18 of China's provinces and regions. After 2000, ground fissures continued to grow and spread. With the continuous advancement of old fissures and the emergence of new fissures, in other words, the ground fractured further and further. In this video, we will discuss the top 10 ground fissures. However, before we get to that point, let us look at some facts about ground fissures. Before we go any further, please give this video a positive rating and subscribe to this channel so you don't miss any future updates. Simply clicking the bell button will notify you whenever there is a new video. Have you done so already? Let us begin. The width of a ground fissure can range anywhere from a few millimeters to several meters. It's a crack that forms on the surface of the Earth. They are brought on by several things, such as tectonic activity, volcanic eruptions, and subsidence. Although most ground fissures pose no threat to people or property, a few have been responsible for extensive damage. What does the term ground fissure mean? An abbreviation for ground crack, the ground fissure is more commonly used. It's a phenomenon in surface rock and soil that can be described as a linear fracture. Surface rock is one of the factors that have an effect. The layer and the soil are influenced in some way by either natural factors or by human factors. A ground fissure may either be a phenomenon that occurs before an earthquake, or the residual deformation that an earthquake leaves on the ground. This type of crack is also referred to as an earthquake crack. Ground fissure can be classified into the following three primary categories: structural genetic ground fissure caused by groundwater mining, and ground fissure caused by tectonic activity and groundwater exploitation. Researchers at home have completed a complicated but thorough classification of the various cracks found at home. Some researchers classify ground cracks as internal force cracks and natural crevices. In contrast, others classify them as internal forces caused by ground fissures, external forces caused by ground fissures, and human engineering economic activity causes in ground fissures. Still, others classify ground cracks as being caused by human beings. The factors that lead to ground fissures. Cracks in the surface of the Earth's crust are brought on by several causes, the most common of which are tectonic activity, erosion, and subsidence. The majority of ground fissures are brought about by tectonic activity. Cracks in the ground could be caused by the shifting or moving of the Earth's crust. In most cases, earthquakes are the source of the movement of this kind. Ground fissures are another potential result of erosion. Cracks and fissures can be formed across the surface of the Earth due to erosion caused by wind and water. Subsidence, also known as the slow sinking of the ground, is another factor that can cause ground fissures. This is frequently the result of factors such as the depletion of groundwater or the compacting of the soil. The 10 largest cracks in the ground. Number 1. Africa's Great Rift Valley, a World Heritage Site. The Great Rift Valley is a string of geological fault lines connecting the Red Sea to the Dead Sea in southwestern Asia. These fault lines run from the Red Sea to the Dead Sea, The valley's length is approximately 5,000 miles. In some places, it can be up to 50 miles wide. Number 2. The San Andreas Fault, located in North America. The San Andreas Fault is a continental transform fault that stretches for about 1,300 kilometers through California in the United States. It is responsible for some of the most powerful earthquakes in North America, including the earthquake that occurred in San Francisco in 1906. Number 3. The East African Rift, located in Africa. The East African Rift is a system of active and extinct volcanic rifts that stretches from Ethiopia in the north to Mozambique in the south. Ethiopia is located in the northern part of the East African Rift. The rift is a larger geological system component that includes the Gulf of Aden and the Red Sea Rift. Number 4. Rio Grande Rift, located in North America. The Rio Grande Rift is a system of faults and associated geological features that stretch from the middle of Colorado, which is located in the United States, to the northern part of Mexico. The Rocky Mountains, the Basin, and Range Province are separated in part by this geological feature. Number 5. The Baikal Rift Zone, located in Asia. The Baikal Rift Zone is a network of rifts and other geological features that spans more than 2,000 kilometers across the Russian region of Siberia. With a maximum depth of more than 5 kilometers, it's the largest and deepest rift valley that can be found anywhere in the world. Number 6. The West Antarctic Rift System, which can be found in Antarctica. More than 3,000 kilometers of West Antarctica are traversed by the West Antarctic Rift System, which is comprised of a series of rifts and other geological features associated with them. The Ross Sea Rift and Marie Byrd Land Rift and the Horlick Mountains Rift are all part of the world's most extensive rift system, including the Horlick Mountains Rift. Number 7. Alpine Fault, New Zealand. A major geological fault known as the Alpine Fault can be found running the length of the South Island of New Zealand, which is more than 600 kilometers. In addition to forming the boundary between the Pacific Plate and the Indo-Australian Plate, it's also the cause of several significant earthquakes, one of which was the Wairarapa earthquake in 1861. Number 8. The Rift in the Dead Sea in Asia. The Dead Sea Rift is a network of faults and other geological features that spans more than 1,000 kilometers, from Syria in the north to Mozambique in the south. It's named after the Dead Sea, located within its boundaries. The African Plate and the Arabian Plate are separated from one another by this part of the boundary. Number 9. North Anatolian Fault, Turkey. And more important geological fault, the North Anatolian Fault can be traced back more than a million years. The Great Rift Valley is a chain of connected geological rifts that stretch across the continent of Africa's eastern half. From its northernmost point in the Tajadura region of Djibouti, down to its southernmost point in Mozambique. The valley is over 6,000 kilometers long. The valley is home to some of the largest lakes in Africa, including Lake Tanganyika, Lake Turkana, and Lake Malawi. It stretches the continent's length. Number 10. Salton Trough, located in California. A geological depression known as the Salton Trough can be found in the southeast corner of California. It has a surface area of about 4,500 square miles and is home to the Salton Sea, North America's largest inland body of water. In addition, the trough contains the Imperial Valley, which is widely recognized as one of the most fruitful agricultural regions in the United States. How to stop further damage from being done to the surface of the Earth? There are many things that each of us individuals can do to help stop further damage from being done to the surface of the Earth. Some examples of these things are as follows. Number 1. Decreasing our reliance on non-renewable fuel sources like fossil fuels and increasing our use of renewable energy sources like solar and wind power. Number 2. Reducing water consumption by incorporating simple water-saving measures into our daily routines, such as turning the water off while brushing our teeth. Number 3, reducing, reusing, and recycling materials whenever possible to reduce waste sent to landfills or to contribute to environmental pollution. Number 4, assisting commercial enterprises and nonprofit organizations dedicated to developing environmentally responsible policies and procedures. Number 5, increasing both our own and other people's awareness of the significance of preserving our planet and its finite resources through education. If you have been keeping up with the news, you have probably heard that the ground is cracking everywhere in different parts of the world. Moreover, it's not just due to tremors caused by earthquakes. The ground is tearing apart in the form of sinkholes, cracks, and fissures, and this phenomenon is occurring with increasing regularity. So what could be the reason for this? According to scientists' findings, this phenomenon could result from several factors, including climate change and human activity. Whatever the root of the problem, one thing is certain: we cannot let our guard down. Because the ground is giving way beneath our feet, it's impossible to predict what will happen next. This video has now reached its conclusion. Remember to subscribe to this channel and give this video a thumbs up if you want to see more videos like this one. Ensure you click the bell icon to be notified whenever a new video is posted. Goodbye for the time being, and stay tuned for the following video.